Hello everyone, welcome back. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the effect of the reactive gyroscopic couple on the aeroplanes. So before this, we are just revise or summary of the last lecture. We are going to revise very quickly. So in the last lecture, we discussed the cause of gyroscopic effect. So in this, we taken a disc which is rotating in the clockwise direction when viewing from this side. So, according to this, this OA is LS vector. This is our angular momentum because of the rotation of this wheel. And when we precess this in this direction, and this is our direction of active gyroscopic couple. So, obviously, we discuss this region, this will chase the tau, and after dt time it will come at this place. Now if we resolve this, we can take the component which is OA dash, that can be a LS cos d phi, and this OC is created new component in this direction which is LS sin d phi. So now we can check the change in angular momentum in particular axis. Here we are saying that d phi is very small, about 1 or 2 degree, but we just to make it clear, we enlarge the angle. So here we can say the change in momentum in x direction, change in angular momentum in x direction can be given by L s cos phi, this is final, and minus initial, this is Ls. So this can be written as Ls cos d phi minus 1, and or you can say OC, this OC vector in this direction, in the direction of active gyroscopic couple, this is LS sin d phi. So now in this direction we can say the change in angular momentum in minus z direction, in this direction from O to this OC, is LS sin d phi. Okay, so now we can use the approximation of small angle. So we know that the small angle approximation, when d phi is very small, then cos d phi can be written as 1. So the change in angular momentum in x direction is Ls cos d phi minus 1, and for small d phi, cos d phi can be written as 1. So the effective or the net delta Ls in x direction can be considered as insignificant, or we can say this would be a negligible. Similarly, the change in angular momentum in minus z direction is Ls sin phi, which is OC Ls sin phi, and for small d phi, sin d phi can be written as d phi according to small angle approximation. This is d phi. So now the delta Ls in minus z direction can be written as Ls multiplied by d phi, because sin d phi can be written as d phi, and this is OC vector. This is induced because of the precession of this in this direction. So now according to Newton's third law, the reaction of vector OC, this OC vector, reaction of this is CO. This is induced because of the precession. This is our action. According to Newton's third law, the reaction of this is CO vector in Z direction. So this is the reactive angular momentum created just because of OC. So now this, because of this angular momentum CO, we can find out the magnitude of torque. So let's say, how did we find out it? So this reactive angular momentum create a reactive torque in Z direction. Magnitude of that can be given as we know that dLs vector is equal to tau multiplied by dt according to Newton's second law. So tau reactive can be given as dLs over dt, and dLs, change in angular momentum, is in z direction is ls d phi. So that we have find out here, ls d phi. So now on the substitution of dls in this, so we can say ls d phi by dt tau r is equal to ls, and dls was ls multiplied by d phi, so this becomes ls d phi by dt. And d phi by dt, we know that this is omega p, precession angular velocity. So tau r can be written as ls multiplied by omega p. And we know that the angular momentum ls is I omega, mass moment of inertia of wheel. This is mass moment of inertia of wheel. And this is spin velocity of wheel, velocity of spin. So this can be written as I omega omega s multiplied by omega p. This is the magnitude of reactive gyroscopic couple, and direction of this is this one. This was the reactive angular momentum co, and because of this the reactive torque would be in this direction, because this was the direction of active torque. So reaction of this would be the reactive torque in the opposite to this. And if this is the direction of reactive torque, then we can say the sense of rotation would be in this direction according to right hand rule. So this is the axis of reactive gyroscopic couple. This is axis of active gyroscopic couple. This was our axis of spin, and this is axis of precession omega p. So the cause of gyroscopic effect is the induction of this OC vector. This is the cause of gyroscopic effect, OC vector. This is LS sine d phi induced angular momentum in the direction of active gyroscopic couple. So always in the direction of active gyroscopic couple, there is a induced angular momentum. In this case, this is OC vector. And in the reaction of this, there would be a reactive gyroscopic couple in the z direction. This was the reason. And so important, and one more important thing, just to quick, you can sense the direction of reactive gyroscopic couple. You can use this angular momentum vector always chase the tau active gyroscopic couple. So in this also, you can say this was the direction of tau active gyroscopic couple. This was the LS angular momentum. So this will chase the tau. This will come in this direction. Or if this is the direction, then in this direction, in the direction of active gyroscopic couple, there is a induced angular momentum. And in the reaction of this, there would be this vector. And because of this, there would be a reactive gyroscopic couple. So we can, these two important things, this one, and this is the cause for gyroscopic effect. And in this, we use the Newton's second law, dls is equal to tau dot dt, to find out the magnitude of this t and the sense of the rotation of dls, or we can say creation of dls. Dls is this one. So we know that dls is in the direction of tau. From this also we can say, so in this we are using right hand screw rule, Newton's second law, Newton's third law. So this was the all about the second lecture. Now we'll use this to find out the effect of reactive gyroscopic couple on aeroplane. So this is the case when viewing from the rear, rotor of this aeroplane in clockwise direction. If we are viewing from rear side from here, so this is rotating in clockwise direction, or you can say this is the sense of rotation clockwise. And plane is taking left turn. This plane is taking left turn. So now we need to find out the effect of gyroscopic couple on this aeroplane. So for this is the rotor. Let's say the rotor is, from right hand rule, we can draw the angular momentum vector. This would be the R, initial angular momentum vector. This is LS. So this is taking the left turn. So you can say after some time, this would be LS and this is d phi angle. So from here we can sense if this is our x-axis and suppose this is our y-axis and y-axis is axis of precession. So this is precessing in this direction and this is our, let's say this is our z. So we know that, so this would be our DLS. So we know that this DLS would be in the direction of active gyroscopic couple. So this is the direction of active gyroscopic couple and reactive gyroscopic couple would be in the opposite direction. So this is the direction of reactive gyroscopic couple. So now we can say this would be our axis of reactive gyroscopic couple. If this is the direction, then according to right hand rule, the sense of rotation would be this. So if this is the sense of rotation, this same sense of rotation would be on the aeroplane. This is the reactive gyroscopic couple. So the effect of this, the nose would be nose of plane would be lifted and tail would go in downward direction. So we can say tail will be dipped. So this would be the effect of gyroscopic reactive couple on the plane when it's taking the right turn. So this is how we can find out the effect of gyroscopic couple on the plane. In the next lecture, we are going to discuss more case of the plane if it's taking the right turn.